Today I'm going to show you how I made all these 3D objects inside of Illustrator and not Blender. And yes, Illustrator is the flat vector graphics software. And I used a flat vector graphics software to create 3D models and exported that into Blender. You know what? Let me just show you how it works. So let's start off by creating the shape inside of Illustrator. I'm going to drag and drop this in here so we can reference it. So it's basically a bunch of circles. I'm just going to like quickly show you how I made it. I'm going to select all this and divide. I'm going to ungroup them, set this to white. If I drag it over here, you can see we have made all these shapes separate. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into Effect, 3D and Material, Extrude and Bevel. Rotate it with this anchor point over here, it's going to rotate it. And like it's not perfect, but it's getting the thing done. What I'm going to do is I'm going to select Inflate. So basically it's going to inflate all the shapes we have. And if I inflate it on both sides, right now, without this, like one side is flat and one side is inflated. But if I'm going to inflate both sides, it's going to get inflated on both sides. Going to decrease the depth. And also like from this angle, it's a bit difficult to understand what's happening, right? So I'm going to go into our rotation and select front. It's a much more easier way to understand what's happening. And now that looks good. Now what we need to do is we need to export this from Illustrator as a 3D object so that we can use this inside of Blender. For that, if I scroll down, you can see we have export 3D object in here. If I select that, we can see all the elements are separate. We don't want to export it like this because if we are going to import every single element into Blender, we have to pack them together. Like it is not going to be a link. Instead, I'm going to select all the elements, click this button, which is going to create a single object from all those elements. And in here, we can select which file it should be outputted as. We are going to use an OBJ file. I'm going to save it in my desktop. And that's done. Now I'm going to open up my Blender. I'm going to import an OBJ. Go to desktop and select our OBJ file. And there it is. We have our 3D object inside of Blender. So that is how you can create some really cool shapes inside of Illustrator very easily and export that into Blender. Let me also show you some more fun iterations I did with this type of method. Like this was done like that. This was also done with inflate. This was also done with inflate. I will show you how I made this. This is also the same method, but slightly different. We come over here. What if I gave you my Blender project files for free, with which you can really understand how I create my materials, animation, lighting, and even render settings inside of Blender? Sign up for my newsletter and I will send you a project file every single week. Link will be in the description. This is the primary object I had. I divided it with these lines and I got this. This is like the outline version of it. And what I did was, again, go to Effect, 3D, Extrude and Bevel. Going to set this to front. Earlier we did inflate, right? For this I did extrude. And if I'm going to select this bevel, you can see what it's doing. Go into our bevel settings and increase my width. And right now you can see we are getting a super sharp fall off, which is kind of difficult if you are trying to recreate this inside of Blender because you have to worry about a lot of topology issues that might come up. And again, inside of over here, we have different settings as well. Yeah, like it's this shape inflated. That's how I made this. So there is definitely a lot of different ways to create some really cool looking shapes very easily using Illustrator and exporting that into Blender. Because if we are going to recreate all these shapes inside of Blender itself, it is going to take a lot of time. Like we have to worry about a lot of things, especially the topology. So I hope you found this video helpful. Subscribe for more Blender stuff.